from around the globe. It's theCUBE with digital coverage of DockerCon Live 2020. Brought to you by Docker and its ecosystem partners.
Hey, welcome back to the DockerCon 2020 virtual headquarters. I'm John Furrier with theCUBE here in our Palo Alto CUBE studios with Jenny Briscio, my co-host. We're bumpering
into
sessions. Jenny, you looking good. You're surviving. The internet hasn't broken yet. How you doing? Everything going well?
Internet hasn't broken. We are doing great. Seeing tons of engagement across the sessions. I know we've given our audience and our community a lot of really good content to choose from, and that will continue throughout the rest of the day. We definitely want to hear in chat on Twitter what your favorite sessions are. Share hashtag Dr. Selfie. And as announced in the keynote, right, if you are looking for a job or hiring, please share hashtag DockerCon jobs.
Great stuff.
So John.
Yeah.
I have to ask the most important conference question. As someone who's organized all the live events as well with my dear friend Ashlyn Pellini, the number one complained about thing about a conference, aside from Wi-Fi, right, which still applies virtually, is the food. And I want to know how your conference lunch was today.
Well, we haven't eaten lunch. Lunch is for wimps. So when you're on the DockerCon desk here, lunch is coming. We'll get that on the next break. Yeah, no lunches. I mean, you know, you don't have to eat that the sandwich or whatever food they give. Sometimes it's on the bigger events, it gets watered down. It's an area where people cut costs, but you got to eat. Virtual is no lunch. And Wi-Fi, by the way, you got to be on that. Get with the kids off the Netflix, making sure you got good low ping times. All the gamers know that. So I think it's a good use of resources. And Jenny, DockerCon's free.
It's free.
It's free.
So you're getting a huge bang for your buck. It is funny how Wi-Fi is a problem both in person and virtually, but there's no bathroom lines, no coffee lines, hopefully. So I hope everyone's having a great experience with virtual DockerCon and really getting the chance to chat with the speakers and chat with everyone. If you haven't yet, please pop on over in the Captains on Deck stream. They've been going live for hours and it's a great time over there. Scott Hanselman and Mackenzie and some Docker team. I think Simone is on right now. So if you're looking for some deep technical talk and you want to participate, pop on over to that session.
Well, you know, I was just talking to Stu Miniman about this and some other folks. We need a virtual pub because I love having beers at DockerCon. That's another one we're going to miss. So if you got beers, toast it up on Twitter. I saw some folks putting their mugs up there. Certainly the Europeans were on beer o'clock here in California. It was still early. We had the coffee, but it's been fun. Jenny, what's your favorite thing going on here? I mean, this has been a lot of fun. You guys have worked really hard on setting this event up. The content program, content quality is second to none. Well done. But what's your favorite thing happening here?
Yeah, I think, you know, honestly, after planning something like this and all of the work that our speakers put in, right? So this isn't just, not, I shouldn't say just, right? But at a live conference, you work on your deck, you come in, public speaking, right? You're nervous, but you're up there and you do it. It's a bit of a curse to do these pre-recorded talks because you keep wanting to make it better and better. And then you have this whole production element, right? Like these are developers and they want to do great, yeah. But they're not producing content all the time like theCUBE. So they put in so much effort into creating not only great content, but beautiful presentations and picture in picture delivery to really try to make it feel engaging. And I'm indebted to them for all of their work there.
I think Brett Fischer is the harbinger of things to come. I've been saying this for a while. If you look at what's happening on Twitch with gaming. People are going to start streaming their code sessions. They're going to start streaming their demos. I think you're going to see a lot more personal broadcasting. Kelsey Hightower brought this up on the innovation panel. I think that's going to be a big feature and I'm looking forward to incorporating that in and being part of the contribution on the content side. Again, if we can be an upstream project for all that content like this framework, I think you could have literally 1,000 sessions someday. So, you know, this is the...
I can't organize that, but yes.
Get the standardization. My favorite part of all this is not only doing the interviews and kicking it off, having fun, is watching the chats in the sessions, watching the ecosystem, the 43 sessions. I don't know if it feels like a keynote or an expo hall, because it's got a keynote vibe, but it's got a very targeted booth-like feel. It's like there's real engagement going on in these containers, if you will, these content containers. It's really fabulous, and it's really, really fun to watch. And normally Twitter is just a flow, but here you got targeted. So that's my favorite.
Yes, and I also love, right, with a sponsored event, you're getting the quality content in this format because the sponsors and the speakers are at the same, and they're delivering something, and the audience comes to what they want to learn. And so I think it is also the future for sponsorship and events, and how content is king, and that will really drive engagement moving forward.
Content and community is the flywheel. The data is the engagement, not only individually, but with the group. That's clear from DockerCon. An early takeaway from me is it's not about the individual liking something, it's about the individual to the group. That's something that's not new to developers, so it's fun to watch it play out. And congratulations to you at Docker and all the partners in the ecosystem side, and certainly the sponsors. So great formula. Jenny, thanks for coming on. Next segment coming up is Amanda Silver with Microsoft. She heads up all the developers. We talk a little bit about build. You'll hear about what's going on with Docker, the new relationship, and the CEO of Docker, Scott Johnston, coming up next. From the studios here where DockerCon's virtual headquarters is, I'm John Furrier with Jenny Bricchio, my co-host, along with Brett Fisher and Peter McKee. Watch this next segment. Stay with us all day. If you're just new, jump into the sessions, find your track. Have fun. We'll be right back.